Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of the RV Bandwagon. Preparing to take off in the truck once again to go paint, and I'm going back to Salem to work on that big ass job I've been working on for a couple weeks now, and starting some new pieces of it. And anyways, just using the motorhome to make some moolah, and I would suggest you guys do the same thing. Get out in your coach right now, just get out there and go make some money, all right? Because your wife will be happy when you come home with money. And if you don't have a wife, well, yeah, you'll have more money. Anyways, guys, having a good time right here in beautiful Eugene, Oregon. Hope you guys are having a wonderful day. The rain is clearing up. It sounds like we're gonna have some sunshine for the next few days. I'm only gonna be staying over one night. I'm gonna be staying over tonight, coming back tomorrow evening, afternoon. And because I have more work here in town I have to take care of. Never ending, guys. That's what I'm doing. Painting the universe and doing my karaoke. I've got two more nights of karaoke coming up, which means four nights of karaoke plus doing windows. It's turning into a full-time job. That's all right. I'll take it. Much better than wearing that stupid blue uniform. All right, guys. Until next time, here, check this out. Oh yeah, got the rig gleaming, got it styled, got it dialed, a little bit riled. Have you ever painted on textured walls, guys? I mean, like trying to do detail painting like Picasso? Really tough, really difficult. And I've been painting on nothing but texture. More texture than I ever want to deal with ever again in my life. But I probably will deal with more texture. I know I'm going to deal with more texture. The ceilings are textured. Damn. Yeah, there's a guy out there, if you haven't checked him out, his name's Scott Campbell, and he's freaking awesome, I gotta tell you. Inspiration to me. He's a window painter, and he does his own characters, and he does like his own special characters you'll see on a lot of his windows, but they're freaking awesome, and he does such a great job. And his technique and style is really cool. I try not to imitate him, but I often want to. Really cool stuff. And thank you, Scott, for the inspiration through your tutorial videos. They're freaking awesome. All right, guys, check this out. A giant wall you see behind me. It's kind of rough at this point, although we're gonna be doing a mural out here. A big forest scene, Northwest status. Right here with big trees, mountains, and probably a lake and a waterfall. And this is gonna be a courtyard here that they're making for the new, pardon the light right there. The courtyard out there that they're making for this new area here. This will actually be an entryway. I painted up this door right there today. I painted up a lot today, actually. You can see my black and white section right here is starting to look pretty good. The idea was to make it so that it had lots of superheroes, and you could easily identify it as the restroom, which I did with our national symbols up there, restroom people. And people ask me why I put those up there, because really in the real world, those two characters right there are the biggest heroes there ever was, because anytime you need to pee really bad, you look for those guys, and man, they're there to help you out. And so I think they have a deserving place up there. The pencil, I wanted to make that so it tied the art together, and that's gonna have my signature on it when it's done, Art by Scott. And so that works out pretty cool. I got Spider-Man up there. And I put him on the girl's side because when I watch the movies, I sometimes think he doesn't know which way to go. That's just me. Anyways, so he's up there. Of course, the dragon up there, which I'm going to turn to red. I'm going to paint him red so he really stands out. And then I've got some more foliage and leaves and flowers and various things like that to make it appealing to the women folk out there. It's a bit gray and dark right now. I'm still going to lighten it up quite a bit as far as the castle goes. And over here, a new section I'm working on. Of course, we got Bart right here. He's on the skateboard, and that's because of me. I'm a skateboarder, if you guys don't know. And so, of course, I had to put him on a skateboard. He's going to be here in front of a sign that says, "No skateboarding, skateboarding prohibited." And Wiggins back here has been locked in his jail cell by Bart. And Bart will have the key. But the door will be the jail cell door, and it will have a big padlock on it. Yeah, so right here, of course, we have Lisa. I'm doing Millhouse right here next to him. There's going to be a little partition wall thing, so you'll see them over here behind the partition wall thing, and they're going to be kind of like, you know, maybe not, who knows, it could happen. So, and then the Simpsons will continue over here into this area. We've got Homer. I told you guys before, he will be in this window right here as with the condiments, and he's going to have a piece of pizza. And then we're going to have Maggie with Marge over here, also in the food realm of things, like they're serving up things for you guys. So really dialing in this area for the Simpsons theme. And so we have superheroes, we have Simpsons, we have Jurassic Park over there, Star Wars, because they really want to push this one all the way down this side, going into medieval castle, dragons, and I'm doing some of the owners right here. They're going to be one of them in on a white horse as a knight, and the other one standing in the entryway as the king, and then the other one over here as a jester. So there'll be three of those guys up there by the time I'm done. A little bit of sign work going in here and various other places. I've got to do the sign work for the jail, which is going to say Ollie's Jail, because Ollie's is the name of the arcade here. And yeah, so it's been a big job, guys. Hope you appreciate all the work I'm showing you, because it's been my biggest job. And I don't know what the square footage is around here, but if you measure this mural, it's freaking huge, right? But it did make the place look smaller, as I was hoping and they were hoping. It did really make it look smaller. It made it look more separated. It feels like kind of like a theme park kind of thing. So like my haunted house events, you know, this is kind of how I would do them in sections to create more of the city. So here's a little bit of Hysteria City right here. I'm looking at you in the face. We're back. All right, there we go. We got Millhouse there now. Now the idea is, since this is black and white on the front, I want to make it feel like that white is dripping down into the color. So everything I do is kind of starts out with a sketch. And so I got this little stepladder, and I don't want to kill myself, but I'm going to take you up here. And I'm just going to make it so it kind of drips down. And if you guys are haunted house, if you guys are haunted house guys, just think blood. All right? Because that's kind of what this will resemble. And not all blood is created equal, nor is paint, as what I'm going to try to do here. Okay, so there's kind of an outline. Either the color is going up into the paint or the paint's coming down into the color. So I'm thinking the paint, the white will actually be coming down into this area here, into like the cartoon landscape. There we go. I'll even put a little hole in it here and there. like the background is kind of peeping through. Okay, so anything that would be a character, or in some cases, I know a couple other guys do their outlines different ways, but I'll use a pencil on windows. I'll use dry erase or chalk or whatever. But in this case, this is also cheating, because what I'm trying to do is just leave that white and make it look like it's there for a reason, so that way I don't have to cover up as much paint. And so this white will look like it's bleeding down into a colored area. And now this colored area is actually in an area where I can reach by hand and don't have to be on the ladder. So it's a cheat. That's what I'm doing here. As is all of this is kind of a cheat, because I have such a small time limit. I had to come up with an idea that could be fairly quick, but also tie in and look awesome. And I think that's getting it there. But here I'm going to try this paint thing. We'll see how that goes. The first thing I'm going to do is give it some shading, like on the bottom of the drips, and then I'll drop in the color for the backgrounds and the ground area, which I drew those circles in. I don't know why. Anyways, so I'll show you here in a few minutes. Paint on. All right, guys. So as you can see, I have added in a couple different shades, and it's starting to pull it out like it's three-dimensional. I'll hit it with some black and a few other little highlights, and it should look like a drippy sensation of the white going over this new color section. I've got some more shading to do, a little touch up there, and it will all come together. I will show you the finished product right after this. Check this out. How's your rig looking? Oh yeah, check it out. Yep, this is my campground right here. Check it out, smile for the camera. That's what it says up there. It's a smile for the camera, and that would be the cameras I have on board, because those are the only cameras around here. And so this is my parking spot. I don't have my camp set up going, because I haven't had a chance to do any kind of camping. So it's just kind of parking is all I'm doing here. And this is a copacetic spot, because in the morning, when the sun comes up, this big old building blocks it and keeps the rig nice and cool until 12 or 1 o'clock, which it doesn't really get too hot. It was probably 90-ish today. The rig really never felt too hot on the inside, but I'm kind of glad with that. I do have a power cord running right now, charging my batteries, because I have access to a room. Whenever I get access, I'll go ahead and plug it in, let it charge. Save the propane on the refrigerator. But that's it. The trek, man, out making money. Yeah, so thinking about it, it's like this rig at this particular point has, with traveling and doing the jobs that I've been doing with it, have basically paid 50% of itself off or more. At this point. So by using the rig, in order for me to go out in farther distances and stay for longer periods of time for bigger jobs, it has actually made me money. It's made me about half of what I paid for it, guys. So I'm excited, I'm proud, and I'm just, I mean, I'm blown away, to tell you the truth, because it happened fairly quickly. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's getting a little bit dark, and it's kind of dark in the rig. I turned on the LED lights, and I'm going to go back over to the giant room and paint some more until about 11 o'clock tonight. I will give you a brief update of what the job looks like before I leave. All right, guys, it's Friday morning. Actually, it's Friday about noon. And I've been here all morning painting, getting ready to head back and do karaoke tonight. Just thought I'd show you what I got done. Let's check it out. Well, that's about it for me today here. I'll be back again next week to finish up and continue on. believe we're just about done in the game room area here, outside of doing some stuff on the ceiling. But yeah, added some flowers for the girls. Oh yeah. All right, guys, let's trek back to Eugene. Here we go. All right, guys. Well, hey, I'm back here in beautiful Eugene in the rig. We have landed, and I have less space in the rig right now. We got the new Renogy 400 watts worth of solar power, monocrystalline solar panel system right here that I will be placing up on the roof, and I will be taking you guys along that journey. But there it is in all of its glory, brand new in the box, 400 watts plus the other 100 water. I got 500 watts of power plus new batteries, a whole new battery bank. I just thought I'd show you that. I'm pretty stoked about that. Although that represents something else, a lot of damn work and no time to do it. I will make time. We're gonna get that put in. All right.